Luis Garcia certainly had a very, very great season at his boyhood club, Valencia. And yeah, obviously he was not really given many opportunities by the manager, but he really, really seized the opportunities which he was given in the preseason tournaments and some games in the league as well. Some games against smaller clubs. He really seized the opportunities, as every youngster does when he is given an opportunity. But yeah, since signing for Valencia CF in the last season, in the year 2019, he has really been a successful player, a successful youngster. I must say that, really, guys, we must appreciate what he did in the seven games he was given opportunities. He contributed in 4 goals, assisting 2 and scoring 2 by himself. But yeah, he had a good season, I must say that. And he is really looking promising, guys. And yeah, this is his second season as a professional footballer. And yeah, guys, let's not waste time. Let's go for his very second season at his club, Valencia CF. He won't be playing in the first team as he is now a 74 overall player. He won't be given opportunities, I know that. So I'll be making a loan move to some club. Also, he'll be signing a new sponsorship deal with New Balance. So tune in for this episode, guys. Let's go for the big, big episode. The new season of Luis Garcia of my Player Career Mode series. So hello guys, and welcome to a brand new episode, a brand new season of the Luis Garcia Career Mode series, or we can say the My Player Career Mode series, as it's a Sunday, as I always do, guys. It's a schedule. Every Sunday I upload a My Player Career Mode series episode. So yeah, we are gonna do this, and yeah, this is the second season. As you guys heard in the intro, I'll be signing a new boot sponsorship with New Balance for this young lad. And yeah, as he is a young lad, he won't be really getting some big boots like Adidas or Nike. So yeah, New Balance is a good company for boots. So yeah, we'll be signing with them. And also, I'll be making a loan move to some other club, as he won't be given opportunities at Valencia since he is a 74 overall player. But yeah, let's just put ourselves in the loan list. And as I see, we don't have the option to just request a transfer. I guess he is already on the transfer list. But yeah, let's just request a loan move here. We know that we won't be getting opportunities here. So it's a really, really good decision to go out on loan. Let's just to complete our youth development here. And let's come back to our parent club with some high potential, so that he just gets into the first team after spending a loan move here. So as I just read some headlines here, new players signed by our club, Lorenzo Pellegrini signed here by Valencia. Anyways, guys, let's just not waste time. Let's get away with the episode. And yeah, let's just go for the first game. As you guys know, the preseason tournament is here. We haven't really got a loan offer yet, so I'm gonna play this game. We are getting an opportunity to just play in this game against Roma. They are a good side. Let's just hope that we do well in this game. And yeah, let's just hope for a win. That's the only thing I can say. And the stadium is all set for the big game against Roma. It's a preseason tournament, so yeah, it's not really a big game. The San Siro stadium is really all set for the big game against Roma. And now the first touches here from Luis Garcia. We can see here, yeah, there it is. But now the first chance, it has come from Roma in the 20th minute. Through ball to Cristante, and he scores. Cristante, I don't know how to pronounce that name, but yeah, he does score for his side. Roma have scored. And yeah, that's a good goal from him, I must say that. And that guy scores for his side. And Roma have just scored the first goal in the preseason tournament's first game. And yeah, the second goal also has come here from their side. But this isn't the goal, I guess. Huh, yes. It's the first half whistle. And yeah. Looking at the scoreline already, we are losing against Roma. But yeah, let's just hope we do better in the second half. Let's hope he creates more chances, Luis Garcia. He is a midfielder, so he is really expected to do that. But now, a through ball played it to Rashica, who scores for his side. He has signed for this club in this transfer window, I guess. And Rashica scores for his side now. And this is just really poor defending from our team, Valencia. And yeah, it's not Luis Garcia who has to be blamed here, obviously, for this result. But now, another chance, another goal for their team. Now, Zaniolo scores for his side, man. This is just disappointing, disappointing scoreline here. We are just being thrashed by Roma. And yeah, I just think that we must be really creating more chances. But now, Luis Garcia, he loses the ball there. But now, the game has ended here. And Luis Garcia was the only player who played well. The best player in the side, I can say. 7.3 is rating, rest all just six, around 6. That's just fantastic work from our player. Looking at his just passing percentage, 91% is his passing rate. 22 touches, I guess. Just missed to see that. But yeah, an overall good performance from Luis Garcia in this game. He did well. Looking at the match facts, really zero chances for our side. They really need to work on that, man. The midfield needs to create chances. But now we have received a loan move offer from FC Groningen. And if you guys really don't know about this club, it's a team which plays in the Netherlands League, in the Eredivisie League, the league where Ajax club plays. So yeah, I'm gonna accept this offer. This club is really not the best club, the biggest club, but yeah, I have to make a loan move. We need some great game time, which we are not gonna get at Valencia. So yeah, just looking at the league objectives here, and average match rating, we need to do it better than 6.6 or better. We need to do that. Create 9 goals, okay, that's good. Pass completion rate 75%, and around 31 goals they want me to contribute in. So yeah, that's good. And yeah, if you guys really don't know about this big club, and in the recent transfer window, we just heard about Ian Robin coming back to football, and he has signed with this club as well. So yeah, I think this is a good club. I really don't know about this club, but I think so, they are a good side. Let's just hope that this one is a challenging transfer. But now I'm gonna sign a new deal with New Balance here, and yeah, let's just go ahead and let's give this guy a new boot. His really current boots are not at all good looking. He needs to get a new boot for himself. So yeah, let's just bring in a new boot for this guy. So New Balance boots, this yellow one, not the perfect, I guess. This one looks cool, but yeah, black and yellow, that's a good one, but not the best. This one is really fantastic, guys. Orange and red combination with the New Balance symbol there. But yeah, not the best one. This one looks the perfect fit for this young lad. It just goes with the current jersey. The white one really contrasting with the jersey. So yeah, this red one or the blue one. Just thinking. So yeah, this doesn't really look good on this jersey. So I'm gonna go ahead with the blue one. This one really looks cool, guys. So yeah, let's just sign the sponsorship deal with New Balance. And yeah, a new boot signed by Luis Garcia. New sponsorship signed with New Balance Club. New Balance Company, sorry. So yeah, a good company, good boot selection by me. If you guys really think this one was not the best, you guys tell me in the comment section. I'll just change the boots for you guys. But yeah, now the first game we were all waiting for. or Luis Garcia, he'll be making his debut in the Eredivisie League as a lone player. And looking at the other players in this team, and my player, Luis Garcia, is really the best player in the team. 73 overall his, and remaining rest other players around 70, 71 and 72. So yeah, we have a lot of expectations from the fans as well. Luis Garcia, after signing for this club, let's just hope that he does not disappoint. Let's just hope that he really starts off well at this club. Obviously, he'll be playing in another league this time, so it will take some time for him to settle in. But now, the first chance has come from the opponent in the 38th minute. Burnett with the ball. And still going on. Plays it to Gori. Peña. And Tashai scores for his side. I really don't know the players, but I'm just reading the names from the player name box, as you guys know, really. I just don't know the player. Even you guys won't be really knowing about these players. But yeah, they have scored the first goal. So it's a disappointing start for Luis Garcia, but we cannot just blame it on him. It was poor defending from the defense. And I think so. I'll have to change the difficulty in the next game, because we are not able to create many chances at the legendary difficulty. So I'll be reducing it to world class in the next game. But yeah, we'll see, guys. Now, the first chance in the second half. Once again, a shot was taken from the long range by the midfielder of the opposition team. But a good save from a keeper. Now another chance from them. And the cross is played and punched away by the keeper. Still going on. Once again, a shot taken by the right winger of their team. But once again, a good stop from our keeper. And the first game has ended. The debut of Luis Garcia at this club, it hasn't really been the perfect performance from him. But yeah, Marcus Mauro is the best player from our side against this team. And yeah, looking at the movements and passing rate, 22 touches from our player, 93 is passing percentage, 15 passes completed. Not bad at all, but we see we are not keeping possession of the ball here. That's what the manager has to say about our performance. Rest everything, our passing was really fine. And this was an okay debut, not the best debut I was expecting. But yeah, I'll be reducing the difficulty in the next game. We'll see if he does well in the world class difficulty. So yeah, let's go for the next game, guys. And it's against FC Utrecht. And yeah, FC Groningen versus FC Utrecht. I really don't know, once again, this team. But yeah, let's just hope we score some goals in the second game, as we really have a big responsibility to score and convert chances. We have an objective from the manager, so we have to fulfill that. And the second game for him as a player, let's hope that he does well here, man. Let's hope that he does. And he does recover the ball well, but loses it really quickly. But now another chance. Garcia with the ball. A through ball played to the midfielder, and he takes the shot. Unfortunately for him, that would have been a great chance and an assist for Luis Garcia as well, but a chance goes in vain. And now in the 20th minute, they have a free kick, the opponent, and now the free kick is taken, and the shot was taken there by their midfielder, and that was a good save from our keeper. I must say that, man. And now, the first half has come to an end, guys. Once again, we are not at all creating chances. A chance was really created by a midfielder, our man. But yeah, that chance just goes in vain. That shot just hit the post. And now Luis Garcia, what a run from him. Still going on, but losing the ball. What a run from him. I just thought that he would be going all by himself to score that goal. But yeah, now another chance in the 61st minute. Good interplay between the players of FC Groningen. Luis Garcia still going on. And a through ball to Luis Garcia back. And that was a good interplay by Luis Garcia. He scores his first goal. And the 14 number jersey has really shined in this game in the 63rd minute. This was a good goal. and you see his signature celebration there. And this was a good goal from Luis Garcia, I must say that. He just converts a chance into goal. And yeah, let's just hope that we create more chances, or at least let's just hope that the defense does their job. And it's looking like the game is gonna end with 1-0 the scoreline. Luis Garcia making a run from the midfield, but that chance was defended well by the opponent. And yeah, the second game has ended. Luis Garcia being the difference between the two sides. And you see the players are so happy. Luis Garcia celebrating with his teammates. He was the man of the match. Obviously, his only goal just being the difference between the two sides. But yeah, he wasn't really the man of the match. Giovanni Zwilkestra, I guess, is the man of the match. And yeah, player performance, let's just see that. And yeah, passing percentage 65%, not really good. 13 passes completed, but you see, 3 key passes, that's what we want, guys. 39 touches as well. Not the best performance, but yeah, a goal was really good from Luis Garcia. And yeah, guys, that just brings us to the end of today's episode. And yeah, tomorrow I'll see you guys back again with the Sevilla Career Mode series episode. But yeah, until then, guys, as always, please don't forget to like, share, comment and subscribe to my channel. I'll see you guys tomorrow with another episode of the Sevilla Career Mode series. But yeah, until then, thank you very much, guys, for viewing my channel. And obviously, if you guys want me to change the boots, just tell me in the comment section. I'll just change it to the color you want. I'll do that. But yeah, anyways, that's just the end of today's episode. Thank you very much, guys, for viewing my channel.